Alejandro Hernández Pacheco says he had no option but to leave his country. The TV photographer, one of four journalists kidnapped in July by drug traffickers in Mexico, is now seeking asylum in the United States.
I'm afraid to go back to the other side because I left my family there, my house, and I'm afraid of the cartels and also of the government that only took care of me for 20 days.
Hernández says he and the others were tortured while in captivity. According to his attorney in El Paso, Texas, his captors repeatedly threatened to kill him and his family.
The whole ordeal had to do with a Mexican cartel wanting to force a national television network to publish videos that they felt showed them in a better light. This marks the first time and a tremendous escalation in the type and nature of attacks and repression against the Mexican press.
Hernández says he and his colleagues were released 5 days after the kidnapping when their captors realized Mexican police were close by. And then he was thrust into the public spotlight at a news conference that authorities arranged without even warning him, according to Hernández's attorney, who says his client now fears his life and family are again in danger.
After being beaten, starved, and threatened with death, they received no food, no showers, no medical care, and ultimately were taken to a press conference that they knew nothing about and had not consented to.
Even President Felipe Calderón has acknowledged that journalists in Mexico face serious risks as they do their job.
Nowadays, they're not only a threat to security because of the conflicts between organized crime groups, but also the well-being and integrity of the mass media and democratic institutions are at risk.
According to the Committee to Protect Journalists, a nonprofit and independent organization based in Washington, 22 news people have been killed in Mexico in the last 4 years. Seven others have gone missing, and dozens have been attacked, kidnapped, or forced into exile. Rafael Romo, CNN, Atlanta.